Honorable Shri N. Gokulakrishnan.
Thank you, sir. Sir, the right of children to free and compulsory education act 2009 was having a provision of no detention policy. That means no child can held back in class 1 to 8 until completion of elementary education, well, elementary school. The new bill of 2018 has proposed an amendment of subsection 1 to 4, section 16 of the act, which empowers the central and state governments to allow school to hold back child in class 5, class 8, or in both classes. It also mandates conducting regular examination in class 5 and class 8 at the end of every academic year. In case the child fails in class 5, class 8 examination, that child will be given additional chance or an opportunity to appear for re-examination within a period of two months from the declaration of the result. If the child fails again in re-examination, then the child may be held back in class 5 and class 8.
May agra karunga kripya baatchit kripya baatchit na kare,
also empowers the union and the state governments to decide whether to hold back or not to hold back child in any classes till completion of elementary education. This bill also gives free hand to the respective government to take any decision, as there is no consensus arrived among states with regard to go for no detention policy or to hold back the child. I am worried that this amendment is again getting diluted, because the question of how many states are going to implement this amendment and how many of them are going to keep no detention policy is still not known. Sir, the experts have recommended rolling back the no detention policy either partially or completely. The reasons are that, number one, lack of preparedness of the education system to support the policy. Automatic promotion system derails children from working hard. Low accountability of teachers, low learning outcomes, lack of proper implementation of continuous and comprehensive evaluation and its integration with the teacher training. Sir, till the year 2017, continuous and comprehensive evaluation mechanism prevailed, which later on was withdrawn by the government. Sir, no doubt that no detention policy is more useful to bring down the school dropouts. On the other hand, we cannot hide the fact that the standard of elementary education has also dropped to a larger extent. Now there are 66.41 lakh teachers are employed both in government and private schools. Among those teachers, about 11 lakh teachers are still untrained, and they have been given an opportunity to get trained before March 2019. Further, the government had extended online facility to teachers to train themselves in the name of Swayam platform. In this regard, I would like to know how many of the untrained teachers have availed this opportunity and qualified themselves, whether the government intends to extend the deadline further to enable the left out teachers to qualify. Sir, statistics says that in the primary level, the school dropouts is only 4%, whereas it shoots up to 17% in the secondary level. It is mainly because of automatic promotion from class 1 to class 8, but it is not in the case of secondary level, that is from class 9 onwards. They have to undergo examination for getting promotions. The sad fact is that the children are not up to the standard to take on examination. In fact, this was the system that was wove in the present act came into existence. Though we found fault with the system, the students concentrated on the studies and showed semblance of involvement in reading out of fear of examinations. This helped them to cope with the learning process to greater extent. But the free pass given by the present act in the form of no detention policy could not bind them to continuous process of learning. Apart from the examinations factor, the other major factor for dropouts is the poor economic background of the families wherein the children are compelled to take menial jobs to support their families. Though the Child Labour Act prohibits employment of children, the system of child labour still exists, providing midday meals, giving free uniform sets, books and notebooks, and conducting evening courses would only partially address the issue. Sir, the Economic Survey Report 2015-16 pointed out that only 42% of students from government schools in class 5 are able to read a class 2 text. It reveals that the performance of the students on an average had gone down and they have not been trained properly. This is where the government school teachers' commitment to the profession and accountability to the society becomes vital. If we compare private school teachers and the government school teachers, performance of the private school teachers is more admirable than the latter. In fact, the government school teachers are getting more salary than the private school teachers. Regarding students' performance, it is better to evaluate a child over a graded system instead of numerical system pattern, which paves way for comparison among the students' community. It affects their morale. This may, in the long run, dissuade a child from the process of learning. Sir, I would like to submit some of the inputs arrived by Madhyam, a forum for citizens to engage in policy making. Madhyam undertook a thorough stakeholder consultation and submitted a report. It summarizes the reason for supporting withdrawal of no-detention policy, wherein it increases teachers' accountability, proper assessment of children through exams, thereby establishing a link between performance and outcome. Thereby, it seeks to ensure better learning. Sir, children are the future of the country, and if they are not competent enough owing to non-detention policy, there will be a dearth of intellectuals. Hence, Madhyam opined that the exams are necessary. Before I conclude, I would like to bring to the notice of this August House that the new generation children have more IQ compared to older generation. Hence, I would like to strike an analogy between the robust foundation required for an engineering marvel and the strong education foundation to students for a better future. For this purpose, I request the MHRD to enlarge the scope of free and compulsory education from pre-primary to secondary level within the age group of 3 to 16 years. So that is because most of the job requirements, both in government as well as in the private sector, demand at least a pass in 10th standard. In this context, Tamil Nadu government is a pioneer as it is planning to bring pre-primary in the elementary education from the ensuing academic year. Before I conclude, I feel that option to the state governments on no detention policy
should be coupled with the improvement in
the quality of teaching education and retention of the students. So if that is ensured, I hope that the student performance and the dropout ratio at the secondary level will certainly improve the envisaged by the proposed amendment. With this,
thank you. Thank you. Conclude. Please conclude.
On behalf of the bill.
Please conclude. Thank you.